In this video, we are going to discuss about move command in Unix or Linux operating system. In order to perform move operation, we uses mv command. Already in the last video, we have seen about copy command. The major difference between copy command and move command is copy command is just like copy and paste. So after execution of that command, we will have both source file as well as destination file. Whereas move command is just like cut and paste. So after execution of the move command, we will have only source, we have only destination file. Source file no longer will be available. Why? Because source file will be renamed. So that is the difference between copy and paste. Now let us see the advantages of the move command. The first advantage of the move command is it is useful in order to rename a file. So let us assume that initially we uses ls. We know that ls will list, will displace the files which are present in our directory. It displaces all the files and directories. Let us assume that we have only one file, that is file 1. Okay. So whenever we uses move command, then what will happen is this source file will be renamed. Now file 1 will be renamed to file 2. So that means no longer file 1 will be available. Let file 1 content is high. Let file 1 content is high. So whenever we execute this statement, then what will happen? This file 1 will be renamed to file 2. So now file 2 contains high. If you display file 2 content, if you display file 2 content, then we will get high. But if you display ls, then only file 2 will exist. If you display ls, then only file 2 will exist. No longer file 1 will be available. Why? Because move means cut and paste. So here we are renaming this file to file 2. So file 1 will be no longer available. The contents of the file 1 will be moved to the file 2. Okay. If you use ls, then only file 2 will get printed. File 1 will be no longer available. Now let us see another advantage of the move command. It is useful in order to rename a directory. Let directory 1 contains 3 files. Then what will happen? All the 3 files will be moved to the directory 2. So let us assume that initially we have executed ls. Let ls contains, here we have one directory. Let this directory contains 3 files, such as file 1, file 2, file 3. Then whenever we uses, we execute this statement, then all the files from directory 1 will be moved to the directory 2. Now if we uses ls, then we will have only directory 2. Directory 1 will be no longer available. Why? Because move means cut and paste. So here we are cutting this directory 1 and we are pasting all the files which are present in directory 1 to directory 2. So what are the files present in the directory 2? They are nothing but directory 1 files only. So file 1, file 2, file 3. Now let us see another advantage of the move command. It is useful in order to move a group of files into a directory. Before executing this command, first we need to create the directory. Then only the shell will know which is the directory and which is the file. Okay. So here we have 3 files. So we want to move file 1, file 2, file 3 to directory 1. So before executing this statement, we have to create directory. We know how to create a directory. Make directory space directory 1. Mkdir space directory 1. So whenever we execute this statement, then file 1, file 2, file 3 will be cut from that location and will be pasted in directory 1. So if we execute ls now, what will happen? File 1, file 2, file 3 will no longer be available in the directory. So we will get only directory 1. So what are directory 1 contains? Directory 1 contains file 1, file 2, file 3. So likewise, we can move a group of files into the directory with the help of the move command. Okay. And we have only one option which is present in the move command. Okay. Whereas coming to the copy command, we have another option called minus r. We know about what is the advantage of r. Minus r option is useful in order to copy the files from one directory to another directory. Here, without using minus r, we are copying the files from one directory to another directory. Here, there is no need of minus r option. We use minus r option only in copy command and remove command that we will see in the next video. So let's see what is the advantage of I. I stands for interactive copy. So when this I is needed, let us assume that here the destination file is already existing file. If the destination file is already existing file, then it asks us for do you want to overwrite or not? Do you want to overwrite or not? If we press Y, then what will happen is the contents of file 1 will be moved to the file 3. Okay. Now file 3 contains the contents of file 1. Okay. Whereas if you press other than Y, if you press other than Y, let us assume that we press N, then no moving will be done. File 1 content will be as it is, file 3 content will be as it is. No moving will be done. So we use this option only when the destination file is already existing file. If the destination file is already existing file, then we have to provide some confirmation message whether we want to overwrite or not. If you press Y, then already file 3 contains some content. So that content will be overwritten and file 3 contains the contents of the file 1. Okay. After executing this command, file 1 will be no longer available. Okay. File 1 will be removed from the directory. If we press LS, if we enter LS, then only file 3 will exist. File 1 will be no longer available. So this is about what is the use of the move command. In the next video, we will see about remove command.